Right now, Google and Apple know more about your daily routine than even your closest friends do. Every photo you've taken, every email you've sent, every video you've watched, it's all being analyzed, cataloged, and sold to the highest bidder. But what if I told you there was a way to take all of that back? Welcome to Homelab Launchpad, where we'll help you launch into true digital independence one step at a time. Here's what most people don't realize. Every free service that you use has a hidden cost. When you upload photos to Google Photos, AI scans every face, every location, every object. Gmail reads your emails to build advertising profiles, and even your smart TV reports back what you're watching and when. All of this data gets packaged up and sold to advertisers, insurance companies, and data brokers who know your political views, your health concerns, even your relationship status, sometimes before you do. But here's the thing. You don't have to accept this as normal. There's an alternative that tech companies really don't want you to know about, and it's called self-hosting. Instead of trusting Google with your family photos, you run your own photo server that only you can access. Instead of letting Spotify track every song you play, you stream your own music library. Instead of hoping Netflix doesn't remove your favorite show, you host your own media collection on hardware you own and control right in your home. With tools like Nextcloud for file storage, Jellyfin for media streaming, and Bitwarden for password management, you can replace almost every big tech service with something that you control completely. And before you think this sounds too technical for me, it's not. You don't need to be a programmer or spend thousands of dollars on server equipment. You can start with a $35 Raspberry Pi or an old laptop or a simple mini PC. The beauty of self-hosting is that you're creating your own private cloud. Your data never leaves your house unless you decide it should. Look, I get it. Making the switch feels overwhelming, and that's exactly why I created Homelab Launchpad, to walk you through every step, from choosing your first piece of hardware to running your first app, all designed for complete beginners. In our next video, I'll show you how to choose the right hardware for your first Homelab. Should you start with a Raspberry Pi, or repurpose an old computer, or maybe even invest in a dedicated mini PC? We'll compare the pros and cons of each option, and I'll help you pick the perfect starting point for your budget and needs. So, if you're ready to stop being the product and start being in control, get subscribed and ring the notification bell. Your digital independence journey starts now.